So in this video, I will show you the ongoing scanning module. So we're going to use this Zebra TC22 handheld computer and with a barcode reader here. And we're going to use this as our warehouse, and you're going to see how we're going to build that up. And we're going to do some inbound for these color tubes, which has barcodes on them, into that those warehouse locations. And then finally, we're going to do a batch pick for one piece orders in this cart, and you'll see the smart thing about that. All right, here you are at your login screen. So we log in with username and password. And here's our lobby view. We're not going to worry about that. Instead, we go straight to the warehouse map. And this could be how it looks with your first installation of Ongoing, and you might want to know what you're going to do next. So we're going to build up this component right here, and you might notice that it says A11, A12, and A13, and so on. And we're going to build exactly that. And to do that, we go to Administration and then Aisle. And we're going to create a new aisle. You can give it any name. I'm going to just call it A as well, and then I'll get the prefix down here as well, called A. But I can choose that whatever I want. And it's going to be 3 X locations and 3 Y locations. And then to get it right, as I've already printed my barcodes, you can of course print them from Ongoing. But then I'm going to delete that prefix, the dash, and then just delete the second dash and then put Y. And then I'm going to click my preview, and you see here that you have A11, A12, A13, and so on, exactly the same as in this guy. All right, so we click create, and A created. So if we go back to the warehouse map, you see here that we have this shelving component here. Now, the next thing you might want to do is go to the article registry. Now, you can assume that we have set up some integration for this, but in my case, I did an Excel import, but in your case, it could come from another system, but that's a topic for another video. We have here the article name and the article number, which happens to be the same as the barcode. Now, this list view, you should all columns view, you should know that you can always change, so you can do that in the settings cog, look for the setting called columns, edit it, and for example, let's say you want to have an image, so it should be this one, you can put that, now it's at the far right, and here we can put it at the top, for example. This can be designed on a per user basis, but let's keep it like this, and then if I press cancel, I come back, and now I have also pictures of the articles here. I'll just briefly show you the order list here. We have a couple of orders that with status released and pickable not okay because we don't have any goods in stock yet. But we're going to pick these later on. To do an inbound delivery, you can do it in the admin interface here, just go to warehouse, receive goods if you want. We're going to, however, do it in the scanner, and we're going to do it against a purchase order. So here is my purchase order list. I've already received a couple, but we're going to create a new purchase order. So we give it a number, and that's enough. If we had any suppliers, we could choose those here, and then we'd see products only from those suppliers. But we click create, and then here is my full article registry for this goods owner called My Company. And I'm just gonna go ahead and receive 10 on all of these. Press enter, and then I'm gonna close the order. And now I have a purchase order with status notified, meaning that the warehouse have been notified. And then the next thing we're going to do is select it here and then click arrived, and then it will be available in the scanner. For one of these article items, I want to just make that the first one here. Let's make that a batch article and an expiry date article. To do that, you simply click this button down here, show all fields, and then go ahead and check the batch article and expiry date article. And while we're at it, let's also give it a picking location, A11. So that will be, when we do the inbound, we will be prompted to put that article in that location. Click update, and if I now go briefly to the warehouse map, you see you have a red dot indication that it is a picking location for an article, but we're going to go back to the purchase order list, and it is in the arrival space, which means that it's available in the scanner now. The scanner is reached. I'll show you the interface. It's here. The only thing that it does is add dash scanning or backslash scanning to your URL, and then you will be met with that interface. Now I'm already logged in here, so let's see if I can make it a little smaller. This is how it looks. And in our scanner, we're going to do this one, inbound order. But I'm going to do it on the actual Zebra unit here. So I'm going to close this now. And then try to show you here how it's done. I turn on my Zebra scanner. And you see I have the ongoing logo at the top here. This is actually the web browser. I first open it in Chrome or any web browser. And I put in my URL with backslash scanning. And then the only thing I do is click install app. And then I will get this right here so that I can just press that and come back or come into the ongoing scanning interface. Here you see those options that we had, and this is for demo purposes. You might not see all of those. We're going to choose inbound order. And then I get to choose here from a dropdown. So I choose the purchase order that I just created, and then I'm going to input and or scan article. We're going to find that batch article first. So it's this one that's called Zinc White. And then when I scan it, it says input scan batch at the bottom there. So I will give it a batch called 123. And then it says input scan expiry date. And I don't have any barcodes for neither batch nor expiry date. So I'll just put end of year here. And then it's going to prompt me to give a count. So I'll put in 10, even though I only have one. And then the location suggestion is the picking spot A11. Let's scan that here. And then put in the article, or 10 of those. And then I go on. The next is input scan article, or I can use the drop down here. And let's speed things up a bit. And of course, I could also scan the same locations if I wanted to, but I put them in one of each here. And now I'm about finished with my purchase order. I've received everything. I want to show you a final thing, that I can take a picture of the goods. So then I choose files and then the camera on the phone, and then let's add a picture here. And then add files, and it's now uploaded onto the purchase order. We're going to close the order. And then when I update the admin interface here, the purchase order with purchase order number 12 is now received, and I can click here to see what has been received. And if there were any deflections, it would have been status deflection and red indication with the color here. I can see what I received here, where I received it, who did it, how long time it took, and so on. And then here's the picture that I took that you can download here and open in your picture program. I can also select this box and click here for PDF or Excel for a purchase order note. Let's say I did not get what I want fully from the supplier, then I could send it back here and show what the deflection was. Now let's look at the warehouse map. So we now have 10 items on each of these spots. You can hover around them and see what the warehouse location is called. Here, for example, I have this white with batch 1, 2, 3. I can see also here on the goods flow, goods in stock, see how much I have and where I have it. If I had taken in two batches, there would be two separate rows here. If I want to also see the column for expiry date, I can go ahead and change the column setting, search for expiry date, and I'm going to take this one and let's move it close to the batch. So let's move it first to the middle and then one step down, and then you have expiry and batch. And here I come back to the goods flow or goods in stock view. Now, if I go back to the order list, you will see that we have pickable okay for these orders. And what we're going to do now is a batch pick with this one piece picking cart. And so I'm going to look for orders that has only one item on them. And I can see that here, 1, 1, 1. So we're going to take those, and just to show you some filtering capabilities, let's look for only those with status released. So I can put in part of the word. Now I see only those, and I only want those that has one item ordered. So now I filtered here, and I can take all of those, select them, and then click allocate. That means that goods is allocated or booked from the warehouse locations. So I click allocate, and the status is changed, and now we're going to create a pick order. So, and because it is one piece orders ongoing, we'll recognize, so you'll have an option for pick from batch pick from one in one bin. So we create pick order, and pick order 67. Now, if you don't have a picking cart, you go to administration and picking cart. I've already done that, so I have it. And now it is available in the scanner again. So I open up my scanner. I go back, and now I'm going to take the option batch pick from one bin. It's the third one. And then I'm going to choose a pick order from the dropdown. And I'm going to scan a picking cart. And here is the barcode for the word Kundbang. So I scan that. And now it says what I'm going to do here. The first item is the batch item. So I'm going to pick batch 1, 2, 3 in location A1. So I'm going to scan the location. If I do something wrong here, you give me a red error message up here. And yeah, so basically you cannot do anything wrong here. So I scan A11 and it confirms, and then scan article. So I put it in my basket and then go to the next location, A21. scan the article. And these options that you have here in the scanning interface can of course be modified, but let's not dwell into that. And now everything in pick order 67 is finished. So now let's pretend that I go with this cart to someone at the packing station, and now you'll see the smart thing here. So that person goes and chooses pack from one bin, and now choose a picking cart, so I can scan the picking cart or just choose it from the dropdown. And then now the only thing I need to do is scan an article, and then it will automatically map to the correct order with the freight contract that has been pre-selected. I can just check so everything looks okay. When I press send, I can automatically get a shipping label printed, and I can get a delivery note printed, return form, what have you. But that is Ongoing's automatic printer service. And then I put it in my package here, and I put on the close it, put on the shipping label, put it somewhere where it should belong for pickup, and then I do the next article here. Scan it. Do the same thing. And then I have a final article here. Yeah. Send, of course. Scan the article. Check so everything looks okay. Press send. Get everything automatically printed. Put it in the package, close it, smack on the shipping labels, and then put it up for delivery. Now, when I update the page in my desktop interface, those are in status sent, the one piece orders on pick order 67. And if I go back to the warehouse map, you'll see that they have been withdrawn from the goods in stock, basically. Yeah, so that's it for this demo video. Hope you liked it.